Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. Welcome to series of videos on sensors. In the previous videos, we have interfaced the sensor with Arduino Uno and displayed the sensor data on OLED screen and LCD screen. In this video, we are going to perform capability or durability testing for this sensor to determine the maximum temperature this can measure. As per the datasheet, this can measure up to 1024 degrees Celsius. After reading datasheet, I was wondered that is it possible to read 1024 degrees Celsius with this sensor? So I have decided to perform this testing. So without wasting time, let's get started.
PCBAcom is one-stop solution for PCB prototyping, manufacturing and PCB assembly. Along with PCB prototype, PCBWay is also making assembly stencil within one day production time. If you are using assembly components on your PCB, you should have this assembly stencil. You can get it easily from PCBWay.com. Just choose stencil type, size, stencil side and quantity. Then click on quote now. Check other advanced parameters here, then calculate. You can get it at $15, which is the best price in the current industry. Select the shipment method and complete the order. I'm gonna use this setup which we have connected earlier. Arduino Uno will read data from the sensor and print the same on LCD screen. Now we are in my kitchen. The only way I found to generate 1024 degrees is the gas stove only. I don't think so we can generate 1024 degrees Celsius with small gas lighter. So I think the gas stove is the better option for this testing. I have arranged this setup like this. Here we can see the temperature on the LCD screen in both Celsius and Fahrenheit formats. Let's begin the testing. First of all, let me light up the stove. Now I'm gonna place this K-type thermocouple sensor knob on the stove. I'm using a tweezer to hold the sensor because I don't want to burn my hands by holding the sensor with bare hands. Also, holding sensor very near the flame will cause severe burns. You can observe that the temperature started increasing exponentially. Wow, within 1 minute of time, the temperature increased to 500 degrees Celsius. It took one more minute to increase the 250 degrees Celsius. Finally, it reached 750 degrees after 2 minutes. We can observe the sensor knob color started changing to red color. We'll be right back. Now the temperature increasing slowly when compared to the previous period. It took 1 more minute to increase the 150 degrees Celsius. Finally, it reached 900 degrees Celsius after 3 minutes and the sensor is working very fine. Now the temperature is increasing by only 1 or 2 degrees per 500 milliseconds. If it continues, it will take lot of time to reach 1024 degrees. I think I should increase the surface contact of the sensor with the flame. Let's try and see what happens. Yeah, now the temperature started increasing fast. Finally we have reached 1023.75 degrees Celsius. Which is equivalent to 1024 degrees Celsius. Yeah, now we can say we can measure 1024 degrees Celsius with this K-type thermocouple sensor. And you can see that the sensor now turned to completely red color. Now you can see that the temperature is decreasing as I have taken out. It is a sign that the sensor is still working. We have to be careful while handling these at higher temperatures. Let's put back to the flame and see whether it will work or not. Surprisingly, the sensor is still working and giving us temperatures seamlessly. Again, the temperature reached 1024 degrees. Now I'm impressed with the performance of this sensor. It is working at higher temperatures as normal as lower temperatures. So, coming to the summary of the testing, the maximum temperature we have reached is 1023.75 degrees Celsius and the sensor is working fine after reaching the maximum temperatures seamlessly. And the response of the sensor with the temperature is very good. If your project needs a high temperature measurement, the sensor is recommended to use because this will never let you down. So that's it for this tutorial. This is how I have generated 1024 degrees Celsius and tested the K-type thermocouple sensor's maximum measurable temperature. If you want me to test any other sensor, please let me know in the comment section. We will try to test it. In the next video, we will interface this sensor with ESP32 and display the sensor's data on web server. See you soon on the next video. Bye-bye.